From the bubonic plague to tuberculosis, pandemics have historically changed the way our cities are designed, and the coronavirus has been no different.
Coronavirus is a moment in which every policymaker can make a U-turn.
Lockdown made our capitals quieter, greener, and we've seen wildlife blossoming like never before.
It's like in paradise for me now. You can see maybe 10,000 of bicycles everywhere.
We're traveling around Europe, meeting the people who are trying to implement the biggest changes in cities we've seen in decades.
3 months ago, here you had a lot of cars in this path. Okay, now it's for bicycle.
But this rapid shift towards pedal power has created a problem.
I just went there and it was empty, you know. There were no bikes.
Could the pandemic see a shift to more environmentally friendly modes of transport?
No, non è facile la convivenza.
No.
Or will we simply return to the way we were? Dutch bike lanes are the envy of the world.
It's so much part of us. It is as if we are all born with a bike. Like you take a shopping bag, you take your bike.
But it wasn't always this way. Marcia van Putten was a Dutch politician.
This is me and my son, 1976. Netherlands traffic is in Europe the most dangerous for children.
Marcia was a key player in the movement that transformed Dutch cities in the 1960s and 70s.
The start was there in the 70s when people got alarmed about the figures of children on the way to school, that the accidents, the numbers were so high. But we had to do something, and that's how it began.
Here, the action groups, and this is us. We want a car-free Sunday, at least once a month. That was in the oil crisis.
In 1973, Marcia launched a campaign called Stop the Child Murder.
We sat together and we said, this can't go on. We have to do something. And so more and more actions were taken. We were blocking roads. In the rush hour, people on their way home. Drivers totally overtaken and surprised about mothers in a circle on the corners of the road, blocking it.
And there you are, right at the front.
Maybe, yeah, me and this.
Marcia's efforts have been immortalized as the heroine of a new children's book.
Here we went through the tunnel under the water, here in, and then the other side, the police was there.
The demand of space by the car traffic was so enormous that was eating up the space for cyclists and also pedestrians. The whole infrastructure of the Netherlands was totally focused on priority of cars. Bikes was not an issue.
Today, Amsterdam has 767 kilometers of cycle lanes and more bikes than people. But even here, the pandemic is changing the way people get about.
Because of COVID-19, it didn't feel right to go by tram anymore. So it was actually the right time to now get a bakfiets cargo bike.
Judith and Johan Hartog bought an electric cargo bike right at the start of lockdown.
We're not really going on a vacation now, so it's like a staycation. We stay in Holland and we do a lot by bike now, so it's you can put a lot of things in. You can get the bags and go out, like here in the park, and we're going to the beach by bike. So it's easy for days off.
Could you have imagined having this, being this Dutch
yeah,
man,
no,
6 months?
Yeah, no, we would never have thought. So yeah, it's fun. It's different, And it's also a bit cliché, but yeah, we like it. We love it.
The pandemic has been a catalyst for many people here to invest savings they wouldn't otherwise have had.
It's not only mobility anymore, you know, because it's also fun. They're singing in the bike and they have fun, you're in nature. It's a whole different way of going out.
The Netherlands already had world-renowned infrastructure, but the coronavirus has still significantly shifted behavior. Cargo bike sales have gone up by 53% this year, and the e-bike is now the most commonly sold type of bicycle. Brussels, the capital of Belgium. Since March, it's built 40 kilometers of new cycle paths.
I've been here for 2 weeks, and then all of a sudden, the world changed. So, of course, I decided that I want to, you know, take all the measures that I can to stay healthy.
When Brussels went into lockdown, Veselina Fateva decided cycling was the fastest, safest way to travel and went out to buy a bike.
I just entered the bike shop and I had this image of myself, you know, buying a beautiful bike and matching with a nice helmet. But I just went there and it was empty, you know. There were no bikes. I wanted to order one, but they said that I need to wait at least 2 months to get a bike. So I said, okay, no way, I cannot wait so much because, you know, the whole summer will be gone. A friend of mine, really by accident, told me that she heard about this subscription-based service where you can pay a monthly fee and get the bike at your home. So I thought that that's really cool.
Commuters make up the majority of those who've subscribed to this particular scheme, Swap Fees. The Dutch company is expanding into 3 new cities to capitalize on a spike in demand that came with COVID.
When it was already official that we are living in a global pandemic, I decided that I will avoid as much as possible public transport. So this is probably the main reason to decide to have a bike.
But it's not just commuters who are switching to two wheels. Cycling traffic surged in Brussels during the first week of the return to school, with a 75% increase compared to last year. Milan was one of the first cities to embrace cycling as a way to get its residents moving around again.
This is one of Italy's most polluted cities and is also in the heart of the region. It was the epicenter of the outbreak in Europe.
Signorina, io le dico che ho fatto, ho vissuto qua nel tempo di guerra. Questo mi pareva più brutto che la guerra là. Quando morivano tanti, io avevo paura, il 90% erano vecchi. E allora mi sono un po' spaventato.
Pepino Dralli is one of Italy's most famous bike manufacturers. Now, at 92, Pepino has been building bikes for more than 80 years.
Se vengo in bottega con la mia canina che viene a prendermi in macchina quello là, perché qua vivo.
And the crisis has meant an unparalleled pressure on Pepino and his apprentice Alessandro.
El maestro Miyagi.
As the demand for their handmade bikes has soared.
Abbiamo aperto il 5 maggio, c'era la gente con la bicicletta a mano fino là in fondo, tutti in fila. Sì, è abbastanza complicato da imparare soprattutto. E anche adesso, dopo il coronavirus, molti pezzi non si trovavano più, perché con tutte le riparazioni che ci sono state non si trovavano più I pezzi perché sono andati quasi tutti esauriti.
But Pepino isn't convinced the boost to their sales is reflected in the number of actual cyclists on the streets.
Avevo detto la mattina alle 6 sullo stradone c'erano 200-300 biciclette che le persone venivano a lavorare in bicicletta a Milano. Adesso sullo stradone vede mille macchine e una bicicletta.
Are you hopeful that in the future it will again be like it was when you were a boy?
Forse perché sono vecchio, scusatemi. Io dico di no. Perché al giorno d'oggi è cambiato il mondo. Uno va a prendere il giornale e va con la macchina.
And there are many who hope Pepino is right, that the surge in cycling is just a phase. Claudio Sevignini is slipping back into his old routine. He's been driving passengers around Milan for more than two decades.
E vedete, il nostro posteggio è a destra e bisogna attraversare la pista ciclabile per entrare nel posteggio taxi.
That's incredible. So you have to cross the cycle lane to go into your taxi rank here.
But the roads he knows, like the back of his hand, are being altered, and he's worried about cars being pushed out.
Il servizio taxi è un po' come la cartina al tornasole del movimento della città. Quindi se la città si muove, il taxi si muove. Anche in altri era più facile vedere una persona che aspettava il taxi piuttosto che tanti taxi che aspettavano le persone.
Claudio is concerned these bike lanes through the heart of his city have appeared too fast without enough consideration for cars.
No, non è facile la convivenza.
No.
Automobilisti e motociclisti e anche ciclisti sono sempre stati, come dire, di difficile convivenza nelle città, soprattutto nelle città con centri medievali.
And it's already causing a lot of conflict. Transforming the roads, making room for cyclists, involves taking sections away from the drivers.
Questa prima era una strada con tre corsie, oggi è diventata una sola.
And this side is also new?
Yes, that side is correct. The parking, oversight.
The pavement. So now the park.
So not space.
Wow.
Tutti noi speriamo e auspichiamo nella città ideale, ovvero dove ci sia una possibile circolazione ecologica e un rispetto di tutte le esigenze degli altri. Forse stiamo vivendo un momento storico di transizione tra il nostro vecchio modo di concepire la circolazione in una città, quello tradizionale, e quello che potrebbe essere il futuro. Però dobbiamo anche tenere in considerazione che, come ho detto prima, molte persone non hanno l'abilità e la voglia e la facoltà di utilizzare questi nuovi mezzi di trasporto e quindi probabilmente è necessario veramente un lungo periodo per portarci progressivamente a quel tipo di città ideale.
But there is an urgency in this part of Italy, as everyone we meet has been touched by the pandemic.
Un mio amico e prestava servizio sempre davanti all'ospedale San Paolo. Probabilmente il contatto di qualche persona contagiata, anche lui è rimasto vittima di questo Covid e non ce l'ha fatta, pur essendo abbastanza giovane. Aveva 50 anni. 50 anni.
This time has forced reflection. For some, the changes aren't going far or fast enough. Most of Milan's new bike routes are only temporary paint jobs. Environmentalists are using the current situation to push for permanent infrastructure.
Coronavirus is a moment in which, you know, every policymaker can make a U-turn completely and change their own cities.
Anna Gerometta is an environmentalist and activist. She believes curtailing car use and backing bikes is an investment for a healthier future. Climate groups have warned people living in polluted cities are more at risk of contracting lung infections like COVID-19.
The failure to have the courage to change now in a situation in which you have some time to prepare the people can be really disastrous.
This is a major concern for the people gathered here tonight.
They are the critical mass and they are, a movement that has been going on for years. They ride every Thursday night and they want to show our policymakers that citizens of Milan really want a different kind of city. There are a few lanes that have been built, but compared to the need and the necessity of this city and the will of people and the wish of the population of Milan to have a different mobility and way to go around, they are really a drop in the ocean. It's a matter of a completely different quality of life. If you have a city where your air is so polluted that you get sick and your children get sick, that is an important topic that you as a public policymaker you should be addressing.
The regional government has so far spent 115 million euros to stimulate cycling. But Milan's urban planner told us many Italians just aren't ready to get on the saddle.
It's absolutely not true. Probably the mentality of the politicians is too old, and they are not seeing what the people really want, and their capacity of their own population and citizens to accept large changes with a very happy heart.
The French capital is spending record amounts transforming the streets to try to make cycling a viable option for everyone.
It's going to be so interesting to see how this massive investment in cycling is actually changing the way people are moving around the city.
It's like a revolution, you know, because before we had a city with cars, only cars, and now we have the city with bicycles, with walking, with public transportation, but it's good for ecology. I know that we have some problems, but it's a priority for the next months to solve this problem, and I'm sure we can solve this. Here it's before, now is the new world.
Okay.
The most iconic change is here on the notoriously petrol-filled Rue de Rivoli. Sections are now completely car-free. David Belliard is the deputy mayor of Paris. He's a green politician who's been pushing for these measures for years.
3 months ago, here you had a lot of cars in this path. Okay, now it's for bicycle. The more you give space for bicycles, more they use it.
Yeah, build and they will come.
Yeah,
they
look
say.
At that. Look at that. It's like it's a big traffic jam, you know.
People here have been telling me how they went into lockdown and then came out to this, a whole new world. These types of changes normally take decades. Because of the pandemic, there was an urgency, which meant they happened here overnight.
Cycling levels after the lockdown increased by 27% compared to last year.
Paris is in a big transformation, a big bang of mobility, but a big bang with public space. We will organize city to allow you to take your bicycle safely, and we will change rules, and we will make more bicycle path, and we need to give back some space to Parisians.
It's a profound culture shift that's taking some adjusting. We saw cyclists being pulled over for running red lights and cycling with headphones on. It's clearly not clear to everyone who has the right of way, which means for some people, it's time to go back to school.
Allez, pensez toujours avoir les deux doigts sur les freins et les mains sur les freins.
This is Joel Sick. He's an instructor at Maison du Vélo Cycling School.
D'habitude, on fait à peu près 150 personnes par an en apprentissage du vélo, les adultes. Et là, cette année, je pense qu'on a doublé, on aura facilement doublé, on va faire 300 personnes. Il y a eu un double effet, il y a eu l'effet de la grève, il y a eu la grève des transports et après il y a eu l'effet coronavirus. Donc il y a eu ces deux phénomènes pour participer au développement du vélo. Alors il y a aussi le fait que les pouvoirs publics ont joué le jeu sur Paris, ils ont fait des grandes pistes cyclables. Donc à partir du moment où il y a eu le phénomène qu'on a là, on ne peut pas l'avoir dans toutes les villes.
Since the coronavirus struck, the French government's invested 20 million euros in a push to get more Parisians using bikes. These classes are now free to anyone in the city who wants to learn to ride.
It's like a paradise for me now. You can see maybe 10 thousands of bicycles everywhere. So it's very becoming so popular.
Remy Dunoyer is a bike mechanic. His repair shop in downtown Paris stayed open through lockdown. In response to the pandemic, the French government started contributing to the cost of bike repairs.
We have a name for a new service, which is out of the basement service, with a dusty bicycle like this one or many other ones. So we have a special service for this dose, in which we include the help from the government. They have 50 euros to help people to fix those bicycles. Sometimes they are very, very rusty and hard to fix. So it's cheaper for the people to reuse this one than to buy a new one.
While other businesses have been shedding staff or shutting down, Remy has been hiring and opening new stores throughout the country.
It was an opportunity for us to open a new city, which is Strasbourg. We opened a second one in Bordeaux, so two shops in Bordeaux, one in Paris, maybe soon a second one in Paris, and in Strasbourg too.
Across Europe, more than 1 billion euros has been spent and 2,300 kilometers of bike lanes created since the pandemic began. Reduced car use has seen pollution fall by 50% in some of Europe's biggest cities. But whether this COVID-related trend continues depends on the scale of the continued investment and how many of us are committed to keep cycling, changing cities, possibly forever.